season and occasionally DM who also play Pokemon Trainer.
Yeah.
But as a whole, it's very similar to Mario. He wants to get in, he just wants to get quick strings and get out, but he doesn't have the same cash out. Difference is, he actually has a decent zoning tool to try and force low recoveries and get a gimp. See how Shy Kid can adjust to it. Oh,
wow,
also,
he's
Leaf
going for
will speedrun. He wants to spike you every single time you're at the ledge.
Speedrun.
Look up this man's Twitter. All he has is matches where he spikes with up B and down B within 10 seconds, repeatedly.
His first thought has to be, what's the quickest way I can end this man's life? Mm-hmm. And he's doing just that right now with these leg drops right now. Shy Guy keeping it relatively even right now. Great swap right there. See, that's one of the things I'm talking about. You can really throw off someone's momentum and what they're going to do next if you mix up your swaps correctly. Because you can literally, the end lag off of that is not a lot. You can get a quick aerial right out of it and turn your disadvantage right into an advantage.
And the fact that Meebrawler doesn't have a true confirm of any kind to get a guaranteed kill, you don't want to give up air dodges for free. Having Pokemon Trainer switch gives them a little bit more room to work with, and you saw it work before. Don't know if it's going to keep working. Trying to catch him with the side B on a potential roll, but not going to hit him. Shy Guy doing a good job just kind of spacing him out. I like it. Like, don't give a brawler too much room.
One thing I like is that Shy Guy is already trying to understand Leaf's neutral. I've seen a lot of Ivysaurs just throw out Razor Leaf just to... Like, I can understand that mentality, but you really, to get a read on your opponent, you need to actually interact with them and start playing with them in neutral. Most Ivysaurs will throw Razor Leaf out, and once someone gets in close, they won't know too much what to do. That being said, though, Leaf, keeping this lead pretty nice right now. He's just waiting for Shy Guy to make an overcommitment, and then he runs in. That was an amazing shot put
you
right
see,
there.
He's actually, he's doing a much better job of zone breaking in. Like, every time he puts out the any Razor Blade, Razor Leafs, or any type of pressure, he's been boxing his way in. Using up B out of shield to back him off, very interesting. I know it doesn't work the same way as before with the instant off frame, but using it just to back off pressure and consistently catching with these backers at the ledge, I don't know what Shy Guy's gonna do to make the adjustments right now.
Interesting swap right there. I feel like Ivy would have been able to make it back, but I'm guessing, I don't know what Shy Guy is exactly looking for with that specific swap, because I know there's no more fatigue anymore. Mm-hmm.
I think potentially just trying to get more weight, you know, now he's at kill percent and he can't see all the kill. Now this throw should finally do it though.
All right, yeah, that will take it off. You know, with Shy Guy with an impressive amount of rage back on him. I mean, Leet's got his work cut out for him. He's forget the U.S. Olympic team, man. Put this man in for the shot put on that.
Mm-hmm. But his accuracy with shot put is very
good.
It's very high.
He clearly knows his spacing with the character, which shows how much time he's put in thus far.
Mm-hmm. When we talk about unfamiliarity and matchups too. Coming across something like this,
who
where
knows
do
how
you,
to
where do you practice
me,
this?
Yo, my boy Johnny from the suburbs. He's got a pocket meat, bro. It's pretty good.
Listen,
it's like, what do?
You go to a random college tournament. Yeah. Somebody says that they're taking over the entire scene. This is where you'll find. Problem is, Lee actually does that for real.
He does,
and he actually wins.
He's been repping it since like day one too. I remember in four, he was playing all the low tiers out here.
Yeah, but good thing on Shy Guy as well, though. He's sitting at 178% and actually slowly creeping his back. Now, we already know the kill potential that Ivysaur has.
Yeah.
If he catches him with one of these up airs at the top, he's going to take the lead.
No, if this Ivysaur ever wants to evolve, Leaf is just going to be like, nah, stay exactly the way you are right now because you're perfect.
Yes, you are perfect to me, but you're currently dead. So let's go ahead and swap into all three, because apparently
swaps.
He's just an Ivysaur main.
I mean, it's so funny, because in the beginning he did try to swap, but I think he realized that he knows his Ivysaur the best, and Ivysaur, in this point in the meta, has the most tools to deal with many characters in the meta. The problem, I think, is he's got a little bit of matchup unfamiliarity, but
agreed.
I feel like Meebrawler is sort of linear. The neutral, I think Lead is also just doing a great job of being patient, really making the most out of his punishes.
Mm-hmm.
And then once he realizes he can't push his advantage to any further, back off, reset neutral, start throwing out that shot put, and then you're good again. Now he has to play neutral all over again, and Shy Guy hasn't been able to get any punishes whatsoever.
And you start to notice that Lee is going for a more bait and punish approach. Now the back throw is going to finally take that stock. Lee has decided, instead of kind of blitzing in where he had that lead, where he was going before, he was letting him bait out the option. Ooh, get off the ledge.
That's
there. That could have been an easy way to steal a stock.
Right now, just trying to feel it out. Lead, you notice the change Lead has made from the beginning of the game. He's kind of mellowed out a bit more, because at the beginning, his foot was fully on the gas. And then the police kind of pulled up and said, sir, I'm going to need you to slow down a little bit.
Unfortunately, some personal experience, they're pretty quick about pulling you over all this way. But you know, you could see Shy Guy as well. He looks like he's trying to establish the zoning approach. He wants to back off Lee and regain the pace control. That would have sucked if he stayed at the ledge because of how short the time is at the ledge now. That down B would have spiked him.
I would not underestimate Shy Guy's ability to come back, because Ivysaur does an amazing job of keeping characters that have trouble landing in the air. I mean, that up air hitbox can literally fit, I think, four Ivysaurs inside of it. So, but that excellently spaced back air is going to wrap up that game run right there. Lee just showing a lot of patience. It's clear that he's been thoroughly disciplined from how the Mii Fighters worked in Smash 4.
Mm-hmm. And you can see as well, like, he knows full well that there's no confirms he could go for, but he's conditioning Shy Guy to jump where he wants and to land in the spaces he needs. Because to play a character like this, you have to set up the kill. It doesn't just come to you for free. You have to make them go to where you want, and Leet's conditioning is really outpacing Shy Guy right now.
I think the thing is that Shy Guy needs his setup to win, but Leet knows that he doesn't have a setup. He just needs to win neutral cleanly and then get that one strong hit. So it allows him to be like, okay, I'm not fishing for anything crazy right now. I can just keep tacking on my damage at my leisure, make sure I'm holding this lead, and then when his neutral's lackluster, get that finishing blow. Mm-hmm. The thing is, also with how the matchup experience is working, I guarantee many people in this venue have at least played one Pokemon trainer before.
Yeah.
Because it's such a very... Currently in the meta, I've seen a lot of Pokemon trainers. How many Mii Brawlers have you seen?
One. Actually, no, two. I saw it at Squad Strike during Glitch. That was it. But, you know, we were talking earlier about the fact that Shy Guy was doing very well recently in a lot of performances due to his adjustment factor. He's done a good job of really changing pace. Like, all right, I see what happened first round. And that's a huge key to people who are growing, understanding how to deal with all the conditioning that just happened to you. So let's see if he can make the adjustment. But Lee is not normally one that's easily fooled.
So this counter pick I actually love a ton, because you notice how much Leet used that extra space with Pokemon Stadium to really just reset his neutral. Here where you've got Triplats where Ivysaur can really catch you pretty off guard, it forces Leet to play a little bit more of a close quarter combat type match. And those Triplats and Shy Guy's just holding center stage so nicely right now, because Ivy's got that range to really to keep him out. Like, he's been in center stage the entire time thus far, and Leet has not been able to just break his way in.
And he's just been just enough out of shield, too. Before, the spacing was slightly off at points. Finally catching him with an anti-air, seeing that he's jumping a little bit too much with that up air. You know, this is exactly what he needs. And, like you said before, Mii Brawler can't get the same type of strings that an Ivysaur can on these platforms. You're just going to get so much more damage off of these up airs now.
So Leet is forced to now not play in his comfort zone. He has to now that he's also at a disadvantage, he's got to really start going in a bit more. But Shy Guy's just utilizing the stage's platforms so much to get these up air juggles right now, and Leet just can't seem to find an answer. And you see how Shy Guy's just waiting and waiting in his reserve range. He's throwing out those vine whips on the off chance that they will connect if Leet decides to land incorrectly.
He's been aggressive on landing at like the last 5 to 6 interactions, and Leet has not respected him any one of those times. He gained about 60% just from challenging him too much. Reads the spot dodge with the forward smash as well, and get a taunt on him, try and get himself a little bit of momentum.
The thing is, now that he's put out of his comfort zone and he's forced, I cannot believe that. I didn't think he was going to kill.
I thought Battlefield was going to come in with the assist.
I was getting shades of Smash 4 right there. It's like, is he going to die? But Balloon Knockback said, I got you, homie. But Leet has been forced to run it, but now he's caught Shy Guy on the back foot. I like Shy Guy's patience at ledge. He's not hanging on the ledge too long, so Leet can get these axe kicks down on him.
That is exactly what Leet wants. If he can snipe out an early kill, because those spikes are really strong, especially if they catch you if he catches you sleeping. And that is an instant way to bring it back, but the confirm into the up B is not going to get the kill yet, but just continues to rack on this pressure and damage.
He's been respecting the shot put a lot as well, and that tech chase on that top platform was beautiful. It really aided him. One more good hit is going to give Shy Guy this game. The thing is, the shot put is a really odd projectile because it's at an arc. And in games like Smash, arc-based projectiles haven't been proven through its track records to be the best. Plus, Ivysaur, if you're above Ivysaur, that's not where you want to be.
Something that has always had good track records in the last game and currently, you know, transitioning into this one. Great up airs.
Yeah.
Great up airs, especially that one. That is so huge. He caught him multiple times in that game jumping. That was
a big thing. What's that move even called? Is it like Seed Bomb or something like that?
I have absolutely no idea. We do not have the Bible of Greatness. That is the Smash book with all the names
here.
I'm going to blame Devin for that one.
Where's the Pokemon book I got for Christmas in sixth grade with all the Pokemon side? I need all the moves.
I'm sad for the people who were looking at it initially. Like, you got the names.
Yeah.
But once patches come out, the book is completely irrelevant. Everything is different.
Guess I need a new Prima strategy guide from GameStop.
What do you think about the counterpick here to Smashville?
I like it for Leet because it doesn't give him as much space to be trapped on the top as well. That being said, I think Smashville is a fairly good stage for Pokemon Trainer as well. the amount of small space and ability that Pokemon Trainer really doesn't have to play too much neutral because it's somewhat straightforward. And that platform still gives Ivysaur ample space to really trap on the top platform.
It increases the damage output combos that Squirtle could go for, too. You saw he was waiting much longer than we've seen so far with the Squirtle to try and rack up damage. I think we're going to see more of the Squirtle at fresh stocks longer than we've seen in the last few games.
Because, but, I mean, the Ivysaur's been working. It's just in spots where Lead is able to take his sweet time and just use that shot put, then go in once Shy Guy starts to try and move around it. It here, though, I don't know, because there's a far less space for him to work with, so I feel like Shy Guy doesn't feel any need to switch Pokemon just yet. I mean, it's working out from that.
And
Vine Whip is going to clean up that first stock real nicely.
I get the purpose behind Lead wanting to come here. You know, you want to have less room, be able to zone break more, less platforms. But,
oh my gosh,
I mean, 60. Platforms, all you want, just dropping down with the down B. Like, look, stop this nonsense. Forced to go up to Charizard, going to make it back. But that was such a quick, what was it, 0 to 60?
That man went 0 to 60 quicker than a sports car. That was absolutely, like, ridiculous. My boy hopped in the Lambo real quick and said, vroom, vroom, watch this.
Have to talk to Leaf to put a tune-up on my car real quick.
That was ridiculous. And you just see the amount of space like Shy Guy's been controlling right now. Like, Leaf has to be careful on his landings, in neutral, approaching.
And a big thing I've noticed recently, too, how many times has Leaf been caught on his spot dodges lately?
A lot.
He's constantly just waiting. Well, I mean, he caught Shy Guy that time. But he's been constantly, like, worried about the pressure on shield to maybe parry or try and punish the back airs. And he's getting punished for it. Shy Guy's really noticing. He took off stock with the forward smash, and he's starting to rack up a lot of damage because of it.
So I like what Shy Guy's doing right now, conditioning really, really hard. Lead has been running up and shielding a lot, and it's been forcing him to play on the back foot a lot. If Shy Guy mixes that up where, you know, because he keeps throwing Razor Leafs at him and he keeps shielding them, if Shy Guy mixes it in a grab there, it can really even mess with Lead further. But the thing about adapting is that you don't want to change your game plan unless the opponent adapts to your game plan first.
Yeah.
I like the fact that
Shy Guy has also simplified the game dramatically. Like before he was kind of going in a little bit too hard, trying to get too much out of too many commitments. Now he's keeping it simple and going for only his confirms. Like, all right, I'm going to go from my back airs, go for my up Bs, or go for my back airs and go for my side Bs. And just consistently rack it up until you get the kill at the up air, getting a little pop off there.
Yeah, he's happy he made out of pools, dude. He's winner side, too.
He's been working very hard to consistently get out of pools. He does not normally get out at a lot of regionals. And finally getting his opportunity to go in winner side in top 48, so he's got to be very, very proud of that.
And you saw that, I think mid-set his adjustment was, what do I really have to worry about against me fighter in close quarters? Because, far away he can throw that shot put, but once I'm in, what's he going to do? If he's approaching me, that's his job now. I think he sat on that lead very, very intelligently, and Leet was forced to overcommit every single time.
Overcommitting is so huge in that matchup. And
can't put that ring on it, boy. You got to keep dating.
Exactly.
You got to test out the waters.
You
got
to work. I know Valentine's Day just came up, and that was a good in for quite a few people to get something started. But as time goes, you got to continue the investment. And when you see players like, you know, in the Brawler archetype constantly committing too hard, it's easy to get conditioned into racking up quick damage. And a big difference, like I said at the start, me Brawler doesn't have those kind of confirms.
Yeah, no.